business in conjunction and spelling out the decisions of the SROC recommendation, Honorable Speaker. I have two issues, Mr. Speaker, in applauding the decisions and the recommendation by the SROC. In that, during the tenure that Mr. Chokuda was appointed, I was in the House. 2013, in the 8th Parliament, leading into the 9th Parliament, Mr. Speaker, I have seen a progressive, a robust, effective way of doing business in Parliament under the stewardship of Mr. Chokuda. In that, I saw the strategic initiative of 5-year development plan, or the strategic document arising from the operation of Parliament. Mr. Speaker, there is no way we can go and find a place where we are going if we do not have a pathfinder. And to me, the strategic document leads the way in terms of how Parliament functions. So it is applausible. The second issue, Mr. Speaker, which we are alive to, and so indeed are the people of Cape West constituents, is the establishment of the Mount Hampden Parliament, Mr. Speaker. The man we call Mr. Chokuda, it is my hope, heaven come and heaven here, that he sees the light of day in terms of the establishment of this humongous, gigantic, and very big infrastructure development that is going to see, Mr. Speaker, the migration of the Minister of Information from analog to digital, establishing frequencies that Parliament can also have a standalone 24 hours a day, and then 7 days or 6 or 4 days per week in terms of broadcast, Mr. Speaker. So, having said this, I'll talk about these two issues, Mr. Speaker. I lend my voice and congratulate your office, Mr. Speaker, and the SROC for having that arriving at such a recommendation, Mr. Speaker. And I wish Mr. Chokuda a very happy 6-year extension, Mr. Speaker. I want to thank you and on behalf of the people of Chebu West constituency, Mr. Speaker.
Chokuda be given a second and final 6-year term. I have known Mr. Chokuda since 2018. He has performed his duties diligently, efficiently. He's a self-motivated man. He's a team player. He has worked very well with both honorable members and members of the staff of parliament. And in that regard, Mr. Speaker, I support that Mr. Chokuda is given this meeting.
Is taken care of. Him being the chief administrator of parliament, he must ensure that with resources permitting, I know his public has constraints, but the welfare of members of parliament is very important. And the clerk of parliament is responsible for ensuring that members of parliament are happy and that their remuneration is also benchmarked with some of the parliaments in this region. Sadly, Mr. Speaker said, we have failed as parliament to also benchmark ourselves to some of the other parliaments due to resources which are totally beyond his control. But he must push for a better welfare for the members of parliament in his second term and ensure that when they discharge their duties, they do so in a professional manner, which is not compromising at all. But I must say, he's a calm man. And I'm not calm myself, but when I'm going to his office, I end up being calm in the way that go to the speaker. It's good to be the first talk because you need to be quite thorough when you approach the speaker. So he does prepare you for your engagement with the speaker. And certainly, he's also somebody who wants the rules of parliament to be followed, which is important. No matter what it is, he wants that to be done. So I really wish him the best, and I'm hoping that second term he'll also try and push for a better welfare of members of parliament. And finally,
for these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page 263chat.